You got the touch. You got the power. Yeah.
Oh, hey. I'm Corey Hosford. Let's talk drifting. Qualifying, first run up, we wanted to go super hard. You know, they take the top 16 guys right off the first run, so I wanted to go on their ass backwards to try to get her up on the top spot, but yeah, I went in backwards and stayed backwards for some time and scored a zero. Hey, do you know what? Charge that one to the game. Let's get them second time around. So we waited for about an hour and a half before our second qualifying run. And as I pull up onto the line, I see steam blowing out onto the windshield. Come to find out, our radiator fans took a shit, stopped working, and I'm sitting on grid with a car that's sitting at about 255 degrees Fahrenheit. And all I needed to do was go out there and lay down just a clean run, no mistakes, and do what we do. So we went out there, and we ended up qualifying 30th with a car that was sitting at 260 degrees, and luckily enough, we didn't break the motor. We didn't break anything. We made it through, we made it to the show.
Broke a couple hearts.
Yep. We always break hearts, though. Right?
Heartbreak kid.
Shawn Michaels. So here we are, top 32, going against Michael Essa. And we went up to the grid with Michael Essa. We actually chased first. Okay. I was going down the hill, and he told me to stare at him the whole entire time. So that's
hammer,
what I did.
Drop the hammer.
I was watching his helmet. So I was staring at his helmet, going down the hill. I'm banging the gear.
Shooting lasers.
Shooting lasers out through the gearbox. Yep. Initiate with him. I feel like I was pretty close for the most part. I could have been a little bit closer, but I was close.
You're on his door.
Okay. So I'm going down on his door. I hear you yelling at me the whole entire time.
Fire.
I heard you say fire because he went in the dirt. Because when he went in the dirt, I was like, oh man, he's on fire because you're yelling fire.
Fire.
So I grabbed my fire extinguisher because I don't want to catch on fire. Once I let go of the wheel, I kind of got a little sloppy.
There's fire.
Where?
All over his car. I think he tried to swerve through the fire.
So he tried bringing the fire back.
Yes. He tried coming after you.
That's what
fire.
I thought, because I saw flames blowing out through my feet and I saw him in the dirt on fire. I tried, bang, handle's gone.
Yeah.
Didn't even
work. I remember you guys went down.
Yep.
I'm on the radio.
Yep.
And then I saw this beautiful bird. So I was watching it for a minute and then I just happened to look down.
Fire!
Oh, there was flames everywhere. And then I saw him swerve around it and then he dirted it.
So I didn't see the bird.
I saw the fire and the bird.
Now the second round, I knew how bad Essa went off in the dirt because I was chasing him pretty closely, and all I wanted to do was lay down a clean enough run where I know that his deduction from the first run would outweigh, you know, anything else. So all I wanted to do was lay down a nice solid conservative run. But I guess it ended up being too conservative in the sense that we ended up getting the loss, even though I felt the run was strong enough to get the move on. I know it wasn't a 100-point qualifying run, but it was definitely a pretty solid run, I felt, that could have bumped us on. But judges saw different, and that's what knocked us out of competition.
You know, I made a promise to my bro that if he got in top 32, he wouldn't have to use his hands or legs anymore.
Justin, come on. Go, gotta go. Justin, go. Come on.
Dustin, no moms.
Well, promise is a man's word.
You know, Dustin, he's a really good guy. He's always busy. He's doing something in the pits, always to do something to help the team. You know, he's just a good pepper pot.
Got bubble shoes on.
Let me tell you a little something about Corey Hosford, okay? He works on things, he breaks things, he takes it apart, doesn't fix it. So what I do, I lock the toolbox.
not only with the top lock, but the bottom lock. Also, I put the little crammer in it so it doesn't open. What he does, he's good at jimmying locks. So he went in and went ahead and jimmied that little sucker wide open. I come around the corner, unbeknownst to me, he's wrenching away. So I got my Corey Hosford sprayer. Now what's in it? 100% elk piss. You go after his face with it, he stays far away. Sneezes, like that. And then he walks away.
A lot of people ask us, do we fight? You know, being such good friends, do you guys fight at all? No, best friends don't fight. We just hang out and have a good time.
We don't fight, ever. Never gonna happen, nope. Never gonna see it.
Nope. It's the final countdown!
Fight! Go!
BFFs.
Always.
Duh. Twins Dragons.